This is the Greens and Grains grocery store. It's been in my family for 5 generations. This is my mom, Edith. I never really knew her. She died during childbirth. My father, Bud, and I never really got along, so I moved to New York City to make it on my own. 6 weeks ago, my dad died and left the store to me. So now, I'm back in Ohio working at the Greens and Grains grocery store.
Leslie. Well, he sounds like a pretty girl, first of all.
Hello, my name is Leslie Scott. I'm the manager here. How may I help you?
I don't think he knows a lot about the grocery business. He seems to be kind of clueless.
I think a good way to think of your hemorrhoidal problem is as if he is the groundhog. Your sphincter is like the groundhog on the first day of spring. It stuck its head out, and it's looking to see its shadow. But what we want to do is say, no, groundhog, it's not time for spring. Get back in your hole. And that's what hemorrhoid's all about.
He thinks he knows everything about groceries, but let me tell you, he doesn't know about ingredients.
Well, I notice here that it's 50% alcohol, so my guess is that it's going to go on a little harsh, but sometimes a groundhog needs a little something, a little hit in the head to get him back down into his hole. That's what I recommend for you.
Leslie, I need to give you a message. Yeah. The insurance company requires all employees to have CPR training and certification or the insurance premiums will triple. They said there's training and they gave me phone numbers.
Oh, no. We're not hiring a trainer.
Call.
I was a Weebolo. I'm perfectly trained to do CPR. I can handle it, Ingrid. Okay, everybody. Let's all gather up. Gather, saddle up. Let's get our chaps on and our spurs shined. All right. I've just been informed that there is a CPR test. We all of you must qualify and be certified for a CPR first aid exam. Oh. So I'll be hosting a first aid seminar at the end of the day today that everybody has to be at so that we can learn all this stuff and pass the test. Everybody calm down. This is really why I wanted to call this meeting, okay? I've noticed that there's been a little tension between us, and I just want you guys to know that deep down inside, I can be just as folksy and open book as my dad. So let me rip my chest open for you and show you my still beating heart. Let me do that. Are there any questions you have about me that you'd like to know about me?
Yes, yes. Where's your wife?
My wife, Vicky, isn't going to be making the trip for some reason. Just because one muscle doesn't work properly, she's gonna throw away 11 years. If this arm went dead, would you divorce me? No. No, we just put it in a sling.
No way.
Yeah. She left me because I'm impotent. Any more questions?
I can't go to that CPR thing tonight.
Why not?
I have another commitment. Thank you very much.
What is it? Is this for another eye show or something?
Of course.
You know what? I just... What is that?
This is my skate. What? There's no customers.
You're not serious.
I am serious. What's wrong with my skate?
Look at them. They're white.
Yes.
Women wear white. Richard, what are you doing?
Well, it's appropriate for the costume.
And then,
oh, Leslie.
Yeah.
Hi.
What is it?
Yes,
Ooh, you got a big daughter.
Oh, no, these are mine.
Okay,
these
good.
My skates.
Because if those were, I was just thinking anatomically, she'd be about 6'6 or something, feet like that.
Yeah, no, these are my skates.
Don't set me up.
No, I'm not married. But I wanted to ask you the CPR thing tonight, that is there any way I could get out of it?
Yeah.
Because I have...
And I have to take them.
Oh,
yeah,
you got something else going on.
I have an audition
tonight. An audition? For what?
For an ice show. The Lord of the Rings on ice.
Ah,
and I'm auditioning for the role of Gollum.
This is so sweet. You see, because I'm from New York where people have real problems. So when I hear something quaint like this, like you can't miss an important first aid CPR seminar because you're going to be ice skating, I find it so cute. It's like I'm Andy Griffith or something. Keep up the good work, you guys. Okay.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Leslie?
Hey, Ingrid.
Hi.
What do you got?
I took another message for you.
Okay.
And it's the insurance guy called, and he said each member of the staff is going to need about 2 minutes each, and so if he could, he needs a room that he's going to be able to test people in.
What are you looking at?
At the message?
No, before that. You were looking down here. Right there. What were you looking at right there? You're looking at my winky.
Just not in a bad way, just in
it's
a...
It's not going to help me at all for you to look at it. In fact, that just adds on more psychological fear.
I'm sorry.
It's like a watched pot never boils. You know what I mean?
Well, that's the only message then.
Fine. I'll take over from here. Why don't you go take five? Don't look at my winky.
I'm sorry. Okay, I'll go.
God.
Farm. If the horses don't want to mate, we take the mare's urine and we can put it in a bucket. We can hold it up to the stallion's snout, and then he becomes aroused.
Okay, honey, what really cures a man of impotency is, you know, a sexy woman. You need to walk into the room and look at the man, and he looks at you, and then there's the cure right there, right?
I guess you're
right. Do you want to learn, Ingrid? Do you want to learn how to be sexy? Look at this. Look at this right here. Just look at it. Come on, stand up. Let's do it. Just stick it out. Look up. Look like someone just, you know, zapped you with one of those stun guns and you're just like shocked for a second, but kind of vapid. It's like someone hit you. Like you looked at a guy the wrong way and your husband hit you in the mouth and then just no, be sexy.
Hey, Todd.
Hey, boss.
My man, what about a little store pride here? You know, come on, man. Please. Look, what does this say?
It says, may I help you?
Yeah, come on. Let's help people. May I help you? I help you? June, I help you? August, I help you?
Hey, listen, speaking of helping people, I want to help you. That car you got, man, that thing is out of this world.
Yeah, sure. Goes fast. I mean, it zips.
I bet. What kind of engine's in that?
You know, it's big.
It's 7.0 liter, right? 505 horsepower. Now listen, man, do you have a mechanic?
No.
Now see, here's the coincidence, because I work on cars. What I want to do is I want to take your car. If you give me your keys, I'll fix it up.
Well, dude, I mean, what I really am hearing from you is that, you know, you want to connect as people. And I got to say to you that now that you bring it up, you know, that there's some sort of a bond, even if it's vis-a-vis my car, that perhaps the two of us, you know, after my CPR training session, we could go out together, you know, go out and look for ladies, you know, put binoculars on and do a little bird hunting, you know.
You guys are coming back for the CPR thing, right?
He's not paying us. If he's not paying us for the CPR class, I'm not going to come and take it. That's ridiculous. I don't volunteer here.
Buck, you're coming to CPR, right?
Sorry.
Todd?
I feel bad for him that he can't get a boner, but it doesn't mean I have to go to the CPR meeting. Can you believe that?
I can't find my skates. Has anyone seen my skates?
Dude, I have your skates, man. Let's just go.
Okay. Richard! Get her done.
Thank you.
Look, he's doing the Gollum moves.
I know what he's doing. They expressly said you were not supposed to dress in character. Sweet Mother of God.
Can you skate backwards like that?
Oh my God. What happened to my skates? Oh my God.
You like them?
What happened to my skates?
Nah, I painted them for you with the magic marker.
Why would you paint my skates? Why?
Look, I was just trying to help you out. I'm trying to
help
get you in the
out.
Zone.
Help me out. You painted them black.
Right.
Look at my skates.
Okay. Look, men wear black skates. Women wear white skates.
These do not work with the costume. The costume is white. The skates are supposed to be black.
Yes! Nailed it! Did you see me out there? Hope it didn't psych you out.
No, quite the opposite, Francis. Quite the opposite.
Richard Magnick?
Oh, that's you.
Francis,
Yeah.
Can I borrow your skate covers?
Oh, these skate covers?
Yeah, the white ones.
I want to, but I can't, because these are my precious. But I should let him win. No! No nice! Skate covers are mine!
I take it that's a no.
Yeah, it's a no.
Richard Madden!
Oh, God.
Okay, improvise.
God. Okay, I'm coming!
Just
wait,
focus.
I'm coming!
Hear that lone so lonesome I could cry.
Please go to aisle 2 for a special on peanut butter. Best peanut butter, the crunchiest peanut butter you ever ate with your jelly.
Excuse me, I'm here for the test. I'm looking for Leslie Scott.
He'd probably be in the office.
Okay, I don't know where that is.
Oh, it's in the back, if you know what I mean.
My name is David.
Okay. I'm Ingrid.
I'm here.
Where were you?
Sorry, I'm a little late.
A little late? You're a half an hour late, Richard.
Thank you. That is going to be 7:18, please.
Hello? Did you hear what I just said? What you...
Elfin Lord 3.
Hey,
okay?
Hey. That's
Gollum, Elfin Lord 3. That's me. Elfin Lord 3.
Lower your
voice. I have blonde brains.
Lower your tone when you're talking to me.
Welcome. I'm so glad to have you.
Thank you.
Glad. We're so excited about this test. It was supposed to be today. The test.
Yes, it's this morning.
Okay, let me ask you something, David, just mano a mano. Would it be possible to postpone the test today? We're having some difficulties around the store.
I'm sorry, we can't do that.
It's been a tough time.
I'm sure it has, but I have two other tests to administer.
My wife just left me after 10 years. Mm-hmm. 10 years.
Yeah, that's hard, but that has nothing to do with
it's
the fact that I need to get this.
It's become clear recently that I've lost complete control of my crew.
I would like to help you, but
I'm fully 100% certified, notarized, impotent. There's nothing softer on my body.
Okay, I got it.
Okay.
I understand.
I'm wondering if you could find it in your heart to perhaps hear me out a little bit.
May I help you?
Jeez, Carl, man.
That's what it says on the back here.
I know it says that. Don't do that, man. You scare everybody like that.
May I help you? So nobody went to Wesley's meeting yesterday.
No?
No. You should see him. He's back there pouting. I think he's been there all night. He's having a one-man crybaby parade.
That'll teach him, boy.
Everybody thinks I'm a big, highfalutin guy in New York City. You know what I've been doing? Handing out flyers dressed in a yogurt suit. Would you like a double dip? Would you like a double dip? Would you like a double dip? Screw you, Dad. Screw you. That felt good. Thank you. You're the first person who has been nice to me since I moved to this godforsaken town from which I sprung.
That's sad.
Thank you.
We gotta go now.
All right. All right.
Okay.
And we are gonna pass this test!
Well, now we're talking.
I'm gonna pass it and prove to Bud Scott and all of the Scots that I can do this job because I'm gonna do it my way.
That's right.
Give me like 2.5 hours to prepare and I'll see you
soon. No. I'll look. Where am I? Oh, jeez. Hello?
Ingrid, hey, hi. Listen, I've got the test examiner back in my office. He's locked in there. I want you to just listen to me. Count down 10 minutes. When 10 minutes are up, I want you to go let him out and take him to the employee break room. Can you do that for me?
He's locked in.
Yeah, he's in my office. Just let him out in 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
Great.
I can do that.
Okay, start counting it down. Count it down.
Employee meeting in 10 minutes. Employee meeting in 10 minutes, please. 9:59, 9:58, 9:57.
I'm in a bit of a twist, and we've got this CPR test coming down the pike, and I was just wondering if you guys could do me a favor. Could you pretend, play a character very close to your heart?
Is it a role playing?
Yeah, it's like a role playing, exactly. And you're gonna play a guy barely bright enough to talk. You can't, you're...
So,
I put cake in my bum bum. Ha ha.
No, don't. Like you know what? Don't say that so much. And you, since you're from Mexico, I was thinking you could speak Mexican.
I'm not Mexican, okay? That's offensive. Don't call me Mexican. I'm not Mexican.
I didn't know you were so offended by Mexicans.
She doesn't like them.
I think they're very nice people.
I have nothing against Mexicans. I'm just not Mexican.
You're awful upset for somebody who's...
I'm from Puerto Rico, okay? It's an American territory.
Well, it's tomatoes and tomatoes. The point is they both speak Hispanic, right?
Spanish.
If Conchita speaks Hispana and the cake is in the bum bum, then neither of you guys are going to have to pass the test.
You want me to speak Spanish during this test?
Speak a Spanish.
How am I going to pass the test if I speak Spanish?
Exactly.
What do you do for a living? Get yourself this car and...
You ever heard of NASCAR?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I'm a stock car driver.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Are you a professional?
Oh, Todd, hey. Listen, I know you're hanging out in my car and while I'm paying you, but I need your help. I need you to find the Annie doll, you know, the CPR doll, and I need you to get rid of her. Hey, Todd, please, when you're out in the parking lot, please wear your May I Help You courtesy vest.
Okay?
Okay? Come on. Here, let me help you put this on. Look, there we go.
Thanks a lot.
All right. Get to work.
I don't know where the Annie doll is.
Oh, I cannot tell you the day I'm having. Hi, I'm Leslie, and this is my car. Do you like soft jazz?
You set me up for failure deliberately.
Because I wouldn't.
You hurt me.
I did not hurt you. Did you slap me?
Yes, I did.
You know what? I'm sorry. Sir, this lane is closed. Excuse me. This lane is closed. Don't ever slap me again.
I will slap you
Don't
again.
Touch me.
You know what? I will keep slapping you.
Hey, stop
it. Stop it. Richard, stop it.
The employee meeting is now.
All right, that's it. Come with me. Right now. Both of you. I'll talk to you on the way.
I repeat, the employee meeting is right now.
It's pretty selfish of him to leave me in there, and I think he did it on purpose.
I don't know what took you so long.
How dare you? How dare you leave me in that room?
Okay, well, let's calm down. We're here now. Everybody's here and ready.
Let me check with you people. Let's just see how well you're trained.
I have faith in my employees.
Miss, if you walk into a room and you see somebody choking, what is the first thing you do?
I don't speak English.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, she's Spanish. She speaks Spanish.
Well, she spoke English.
I don't speak English.
Yeah, she knows that phrase, but that's all. She's from another colony.
And
territory.
That is English.
Yes.
She understands.
No, she just
understands. You understood because you spoke.
No, she only knows that phrase. We have the same argument over and over. It's like talking to a loop.
I don't speak English.
We know. Good.
Let's just go to the Annie doll.
Wow. Okay, that.
Where's the Annie doll?
Okay, does anyone know where the Annie doll is?
In my bum bum.
Okay. He's mentally challenged. In fact, you should probably have a social worker here on his behalf.
Forget the Annie doll. Everybody come on up. We're gonna do this with each other. Just come on up. We'll use each other.
Go, 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 go.
I think they
go, 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 go,
Richard, go,
Richard, go, go, go,
See, that's how it's done, bro. That's how you save a girl.
All right, good.
Right there.
Good.
Well, I think that went well. I mean, she's obviously very much alive. That was fantastic. Good
that
job.
Was the worst debacle I have ever seen. Nobody knows anything about CPR. You didn't teach them anything, and you wasted more of my time.
You're saying we didn't?
No, you're not gonna pass! And now I'm gonna miss my bus! Because of each and every one of you, you're all failures! All of you, stupid, stupid! And P.S., it wouldn't hurt you to learn English!
Just a minute, maybe we can talk. Just
talk? No, your insurance is gonna triple. Do you know what that means? That means that you're gonna be unemployed. And that means that you're gonna be in unemployment line because of him.
Hold on, just a minute.
No!
Now we can talk about this.
No talk!
Please.
Oh, man.
This insurance company, I talked to them and
Wait
they said...
Wait a second, why did you talk to the insurance company?
I told you all at the meeting and you just got mad at me.
Dave, please.
No, don't. Let go.
Do
let
this,
go.
Dave.
Let
please,
go.
Please, please, please. I'll do anything. I'll do anything. Please, Dave. I'll do anything.
Anything?
Yeah, I know we're gonna lose our jobs. You stole the cut, brother.
What happened?
What happened?
All right. Everybody calm down. When the hand goes up, the mouth goes shut. Just want to let you know that you are all currently certified for CPR, so congratulations.
Yes!
We don't have to take that test anymore?
Nope. I know some of you have doubted me, but I picked up quite a few tricks of the trade when I was off at the East Coast in the Big Apple.
Hey, there's some dude in my car.
That's actually, well, it was my car. That's...
Somebody's stealing our car.
Todd, it's okay. It's okay. It's his car.
Oh, my Corvette, you nerd! That's the only cool thing you had!
Oh, my God!
Oh, bro!
You did that for us? Wow.
I think that was sweet.
It was cool. Thank you. Appreciate it.
I, for one, am feeling a lot of warmth here. And so, could we all circle up and have a group hug? I'm coming around there. I wanna hug you guys.
What are you doing back here?
I just came back here to give you these.
Yo, well, Buck, they're white. I don't need white skate coverings now. I'm playing an elf.
Well, look, just take them anyway, all right? You never know when you might need them. The opportunity might arise.
This is for the chorus. You should not be back here.
What happened, Francis?
It was dark, and someone just came up behind me, and they hit my knees with some sort of crowbar or a hockey stick or something. I was Tonya Harding. She wanted this from day one. You could take this and shove it up your hobbit hole, okay? Oh, Marianne, I can't go on. My knees. I need a chair, a wheelchair.
Like I said, you never know.
All right, man.
I'll see
you. Okay, Richard, that's enough. Get off of me.
Yeah, I'm so glad to be here, you guys. Thank you so much for inviting me. I really appreciate it.
Hey, bro, I forgot. Yeah. There's the bill for your car. I put the springs in, both springs.
You went ahead and did it?
Yeah, well, I screwed the transmission up when I changed the engine, and I broke the shifter on the way out, so I put a Hirsch engine overhaul kit, labor, all that stuff's there. You'll see it. I put the Wolfless one for you.
Are you trying to do the one?
What? He choked
me? Oh, my God.
Right.
Who knows CPR? Does anybody know CPR?
Shake him. Turn him. That's disgusting.
Do something.
Do it. Hit him.
From behind.
And then just breathe in there. Do it harder, Ingrid.
Come on.
Do
faster. Faster. Come on, bro.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Ingrid, I think you cured his little problem.
All right, I see you're in the tampon aisle. There's nothing to be embarrassed of, I want you to know. This is my job. It's my job to sell this just as much as my job is to sell Brussels sprouts. And believe me, people do some pretty weird things with Brussels sprouts. So how may I help you? Sir, I don't think a woman like you would need a douche. So I'm guessing some tampon product of some sort, perhaps? Someone like you would enjoy the regular.